crew of Native Americans several thousands of years ago. The first group to be credited with the discovery of the rivers is a Locke, who is a Dutch navigator and fur trader. After having lost his contact with the Native Americans in about 1609, not to be outdone by the English, the Dutch West India Company hired Locke in 1613 to map the world instead of fur trading with Native Americans. So Locke set out on his voyage to the New World, the ship, the Tiger, who landed in New Amsterdam, which is present-day Manhattan, in 1913. Upon leaving New Amsterdam, this was in 1613.
I think so.
Upon leaving New Amsterdam in the spring of 1614, he set up the Hudson River, which is called the North River. He was collecting deer skins along the Hudson River, but he apparently ran into trouble with the rival Dutch fur trading company. They burned his ship to the ground. He built a new ship, called Automatic, which burned eventually sailed to the river. He sailed back down the Hudson River, he sailed east of Manhattan, which is now the Connecticut River, and he sailed all the way up the Connecticut River to Enfield, where he could pass the Enfield Falls. He went through there and sailed back down the river a few miles to set up a fur trading post at a site that eventually became the city of Winton. He named this river the Farish River, which means the freshwater river that the name ever stuck. Bought maps of entire exploration, which was taken to Canada, which is definitely the federal. He did a map for the islands he named, including Block Island, which he named after himself, and Fisher's Island, which he named after his navigator, Samuel Fisher.
Very mean.